Oh, righty, sorry about that again, but so busy talking about Godzilla, I forgot about the game. Okay. So, in case you were wondering why I said I was talking about Godzillas, because I was talking about Destroyah as a reference to the Destroyer. Why do I do this? Why do I do this? I make myself sound so ridiculous. Anyway, back to the game. Okay, it is Team Apocalypse's turn. If you remember, we killed the AIM agent. Hulk made an attack on the Destroyer and missed. Okay, and now it's Team. It should be Team Apocalypse's turn. Wait a minute. If he just. That means that Team Apocalypse just went. So obviously it should be Team Loki's turn now. Okay. Okay, that's good. Okay, Team Loki's going to. Let's see, what are we gonna do? Team Loki should get away from Apocalypse. Wait, isn't he already based automatically? I mean, if he moves over here and attacks the AIM agent, he was based with the AIM agent. Then he kills the AIM agent, so. Well, you know, it doesn't even matter because Loki has phasing teleport. So I'm just gonna go over here. Okay. See, what are we gonna do with the Destroyer? All of our support characters are gone, so I'm gonna go all crazy exorcist demonic girl on you, turn my head backwards and shoot at Hercules, since he's a more vulnerable target in my opinion. He has 11 penetrating psychic blast. I'm not sure if that works only at range or at close, or if it just it's penetrating, doesn't matter, but okay. 17 defense, invulnerable. Wait, it was 11, yeah. Okay. So 11 and a 17, gonna need a 6. And I got a 8. Okay, so that hits for 4 damage, penetrating, so it goes through invulnerable. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now he has close combat expert, some kind of power. It's, I believe, are you worthy of the gift? Yes, it is. Are you worthy of the gift? Okay. Come closer, coward is on damage, I think. Okay. So I don't think he had that token. I think he had that before, so I'm gonna give him 2. Okay, now he's gonna turn back to him. Actually, I think he did that. I think that's why he has marksman, is because Lady Sif just skewered him through the neck, and he just turned around, breaking not exactly breaking laws of physics, but it looks strange. I'm just saying. Okay. Okay, and I'm going to clear Dracula. Dracula's clearing. We can all count Vlad on you. Son of the Dragon, standing tall. Yes, okay. Throw in a bit of history and with the slang, you know. Anyway. Let's see. What are we gonna do? Okay, so I think that should conclude Team Loki's turn. Oh, wait a minute. He was in hindering. That gave him 18. Would he still have gotten him? I'm not sure. I hope so, because we're gonna let it slide. Okay. It is Team Apocalypse's turn. So let's see what's going to happen now. Okay, so Apocalypse has 1 token. What's he gonna do? What's he gonna do? I'm going to. How much damage does he have? He's still best at close range. I should get into someone's face. But not Dracula. Dracula. I'm just going to attack Hercules. He's a vulnerable target. He has 18 defense. I'm going to attack him with a. I keep forgetting what the numbers are. Okay, 11. I'm going to attack him. 11 attack on an 18 defense. I'm going to need a 7. Okay, and I got a 9. So that hits for 4 damage. He receives 2 because of invulnerability. 1, 2. Okay, we're good here. Wait. Okay, it's flurry and come closer, coward. So I think it increases his damage, I mean his defense when attacked by range attacks. I think it's +1. sort of like a half sort of energy shield deflection, I guess. Like, how dare you attack me from distance? You come over here where I have the advantage, goddammit. Anyway. Let me see. Okay, so that he will get another action token. And, okay, so Hulk will attack the Destroyer. He has a 12 attack on a 18 defense. Just so you know that the Destroyer is not on his first click, though the Hulk did not land the damage on the Destroyer. He had a critical miss while attacking Apocalypse earlier, so he took the critical miss damage. I believe that's how that works. Okay, so I'm going to attack him. Oh, I guess I should give that to him after I roll the attack. So 12 on an 18. Impervious. Boom, need a 6. Oh, yeah. Oh, 11. Yeah, I'm rolling very well today. So now I guess I give that. No, after actions resolve. Okay. I don't know why that's important, but I guess there's going to be some character who comes along at some point who's going to, you know, test that. He rolls impervious. Wow, he gets it. He avoids the damage entirely. Well, that sucks. Sort of. I guess since I'm playing both sides of the field, it sucks half as much. Anyway. Okay. So that concludes my turn. Oh, wait, let me check. No outwit. No, I gotta keep an eye out for that. No, we don't have any outwit. Hulk, no. Okay, we're good. Excellent. Wait, did Hercules on the other team? No, Hercules is on my team. Did I move him? No, I did not move him. Why haven't I moved him? Okay, Hercules is just a standing duck there for Dracula. I should do something with him. What can I do? He's best at long range at this point. How much damage does he do? He does 2 damage? Who can I hit with that? Oh, we have a problem. I guess he's really good as a tie-up figure at this point. But I shouldn't tie up Dracula, because he'll suck my blood. And I can't tie up Loki. Ooh, this is not a good idea. I should probably just get him out of the way. This is quite a conundrum. I guess I should keep him where he is, but then Dracula could just get him. But I guess it'll be harder because of hindrance. Alright, so we'll just leave him there, I guess. Maybe I'll move him like this. He has 8, so I can move him 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So at least make it a little harder for Dracula to get to him. Okay. Team Loki. It's Team Loki's turn. So let's see what Loki's going to do. What's Loki going to do? Pulse waving is not a good idea, because as I understand it, it'll draw lines of fire to everyone. I'm going to send in Dracula. I can still attack, though. Yeah, I can attack. So I'm going to attack normally, a range attack. I'm going to use 11. Then I give him 11 on a 19, is it? I think he got 19 after he was attacked. Yeah, 19 defense. Alright, gonna need an 8. And I got a 11. Why are all my rolls so high all of a sudden? Okay, so that does 4 damage. Oh, he has shape change. We're just gonna pretend that didn't happen. And he got the shape change. So we're going to pretend that didn't happen. I think the difference between shape change and super senses is that if your opponent lands the super senses roll, you get the action token as if you missed. And shape change means you just have to target someone else. So I guess I'll target Hulk then. Who else am I going to target? I guess, okay, I'll target Hulk. 11 on a... Again, a 19 defense, impervious. Then going to need an 8. Oh, that one was, 3. That's not good. Come on, man. Get your head in the game, or your horns, or whatever part of your body will focus your energy on winning. Anyway.